Hello learners, welcome to our environmental science senior secondary course of NIOS. Every country strives to progress ahead. One aspect of progress is economic development through manufacturing and trading. Every country builds industries which possibly provide employment, serve the consumers' needs and help to generate revenue. Development projects in the past were undertaken without any consideration to their environmental consequences. As a result, rivers and lakes got polluted, air pollution reached at threatening level, and piling of industrial waste resulted in land degradation. Industrialization and economic growth provided material comforts and luxuries of life, but at the same time deteriorated the quality of life. In view of the colossal damage to environment by developmental activities, people are now concerned about the environmental impact of developmental projects. EIA enables the decision makers to analyze the effect of developmental activities on the environment, if any, well before the developmental project is implemented. During this program, we will discuss about environmental impact assessment, which is a tool for preventing adverse environmental impact of developmental activities, significance, methodology, and practice. This is lesson 24 of module 7. I am Neelam Gupta, course coordinator of environmental science. Welcome in this program of NIOS. So the objective of this program are need for EIA simultaneously with the developmental project, concept of EIA and its legal aspects, anticipating and overcoming adverse impact of developmental projects, methods and procedures of EIA in India, methods of environmental clearance and forestry clearance, evaluation of EIA and alternative scenario. First, we will take need of EIA for environmental protection. Over the years, human population has been growing. Today, world's population stands at more than 7.6 billion. Human population in our country is now over 1.2 billion. As human population increased, exploitation of environmental resources also increased. So did the impact on environment. To add to this impact was the enormous garbage generated by more and more humans. Further, to make development of any country sustainable, it became necessary to assess the impact of every development project upon the environment. So, environment impact assessment is a tool for assessment of all projects for preventing adverse effect of developmental activities on environment. Look at the figure. Airports, railway tracks, roads, dams, industries, houses need raw material from environment. These are developmental activities for a country. These activities generate waste as shown in previous slide. Waste is disposed into environment. Waste disposal causes damage to air, soil and water. To save environment from damage and depletion of natural resources, EIA is needed. Now come to the concept of EIA and its legal basis. Sustainable development and conservation of environment are necessary for survival of present and future generations of humans and all living beings. EIA is a tool to evaluate environmental impact of proposed developmental project. Every project requires clearance of after EIA. EIA improves decision making for environmentally sound project. EIA takes into account the ecosystem's assimilation and regeneration capacities for any new developmental project. Environmental clearance through EIA is mandatory. This figure shows anticipated environmental impact of developmental project, left side and right side, environmental impact rectification after EIA. The important aspect of EIA are risk assessment, environmental management and post-product monitoring. EIA provides a cost-effective method to eliminate or minimize the adverse impact of development projects. Now come to the legal basis of environmental impact assessment. EIA guidelines follow basic legal and policy equipment. EIA is to serve as a primary environmental tool with clear provisions. Apply consistently to all proposals with potential environmental impacts. Use scientific practices and suggest strategies for mitigation. Address all possible factors such as short-term, long-term, small-scale and large-scale effects. Consider sustainable aspects such as capacity for assimilation, carrying capacity, biodiversity protection, lay down a flexible approach with and provides for public involvement, have inbuilt mechanism of follow-up and feedback for comply into mandatory requirements. Include mechanisms for monitoring, auditing, and evaluation. EIA was introduced in India in 1978 with respect to River Valley projects. EIA is now mandatory for 30 categories of projects, and these projects get environmental clearance only after the EIA requirements are fulfilled. Look at the figure. There are few industries such as nuclear power and related projects, River Valley projects, ports, harbors, petroleum refineries, chemical fertilizers, pesticides, technical, petrochemical complexes and petrochemical intermediates, bulk drugs and pharmaceuticals, exploration for oil and gas, synthetic rubber, asbestos and asbestos products, hydrocyanic acid and its derivatives, primary metallurgical industries of iron and steel, aluminium, copper, zinc, lead and ferroalloys, chloralkali industries. Few other industries are integrated paint, viscose staple fiber and filament, yarn, storage batteries, all tourism projects, thermal power plants, mining projects and highway projects which pass through ecological sensitive areas such as national parks, sanctuaries, tiger reserves, reserve forests. Few other industries are tarred road in the Himalayas and forest areas, distilleries, raw skin and hide, pulp, paper and newsprint, dyes, cement, foundries, individual, electroplating and meta-amino phenol. EIA appears the environmental health and social implications of plant developmental process. It does link environment with development. The goal of EIA is to ensure environmentally safe and sustainable development. Now come to the environmental clearance. It is a green signal granted by Impact Assessment Agency in the Environment and Forest Ministry under Government of India. All projects that require clearance from central government can be broadly categorized as shown in figure. River Valley projects, nuclear power projects and infrastructure and CRZ, mining, thermal power plant, tourism, transport sector, irrigation projects as shown in previous figure. Now, what all is assessed in EIA? Assessment of existing environmental status, assessment of various factors of ecosystem, analysis of adverse environment impact of the proposed project to be started, impact on people in the neighborhood. Now we will discuss about environmental component of EIA. EIA process looks various components of the environment such as air, water, land, biological and so on as shown in figure in next slide. First we will take air, air environment, quality of ambient air, wind speed, direction, humidity, etc., quantity of emission likely from projects, impact of the emission on the area, pollution control desires or air quality standards. Second, noise, labels of noise present and predicted, strategies for reducing noise pollution. Next is water, existing ground and surface water resources, their quality and quantity within the zone, impact of proposed project on water resources. Next is biological environment, flora and fauna in impact zone, potential damage due to project due to effluent emission and landscape, biological stress. Next is land environment, study of soil characteristics, land use and drainage pattern and the likely adverse impact of the project, impact on historical monuments and heritage site. Assessment of impact, economic benefits arising out of the project have to be compared to all the factors which I have already mentioned. Thus, we can say that environmental concern have to make made a part of the decision to set up a project. Next is EIA procedures and process have several components, each one is separately mentioned. This figure shows EIA process and procedures. Next slide shows various steps, process and procedure we will discuss in detail. Now come to the methods of carrying out EIA. Preparation of EIA report comprises the following steps. Collection of baseline data from primary and secondary sources. Prediction of impact based on past experiences and mathematical modeling. Evaluation of impact versus evaluation of net cost benefit. Preparation of environmental management plans to reduce the impact to the minimum. Quantitative estimation of financial cost of monitoring plan and the mitigation measures. Preparation of environmental management plans to reduce the impacts of the minimum. quantitative estimation of financial cost of monitoring plan and the mitigation measures. Now come to the steps in EIA process. EIA involves the steps mentioned are first screening. The project plan is screened for scale of investment, location and type of development, and if the project needs statutory clearance. Second, scoping, the project's potential impact, zone of impacts, mitigation possibilities, and need for monitoring. The EIA agency has to follow the published guidelines by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, MOEFCC, Government of India. Next is collection of baseline data. Baseline data is an environmental status of a study area. Next is impact prediction, positive and negative, reversible and irreversible, and temporary and permanent, needed to be predicted, which presupposes a good understanding of the project by the assessment agency. Next is mitigation measures and EIA report. The EIA report should include the action and steps for preventing, minimizing, or bypassing the impact or the label of compensation for probable environmental damage or loss. Next is public hearing. On completion of the EIA report, public and environmental group living close to project site may be informed and consulted. Decision making, impact assessment authority along with the experts consult the project in charge with also consultant to take the final decision, keeping mind EIA and EMP, that is Environment Management Plan. Next is monitoring and implementation of environmental management plan. The various phases of implementation of the project are monitored. Last is risk assessment. Inventory analysis and hazard probability and index also form part of EIA procedures. Now come to the composition of the expert committees for EIA. The committee will consist of experts from different disciplines such as ecosystem management, air water pollution control, water resource management, flora fauna conservation and management, land use planning, social sciences or rehabilitation, project appraisal, ecology, environmental health, subject area specialist, representatives of NGO persons or concerned with environmental issues. The chairman will be an outstanding and experienced ecologist or environmentalist or technical professional with wide managerial experience in the relevant development. The representative of impact assessment agency will act as a member secretary. Chairman and members will serve in their individual capacity except those especially nominated as representative. The membership of the committee shall not exceed 15 members. Now come to the environmental appraisal procedure in India. An appraisal committee constituted by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Government of India to first scrutinize the project. This committee evaluates the impact of the project based on the data presented by the project authorities. If necessary, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change may also with the investors and hold consultation with experts on specific issues as and when necessary. After considering all the facts of the project, environmental clearance is accorded subject to implementation of the stipulated environmental safeguards. In case of project where the project proponent have submitted complete information, a decision is taken within 90 days. The six regional offices of the ministry functioning at Shillong, Bhubaneswar, Chandigarh, Bengaluru, Lucknow and Bhopal undertake monitoring of cleared projects. The primary objective of this procedure is to ensure adequacy of the suggested safeguards and also to undertake mid-course corrections required. If any changes in the scope of project are identified to check whether review of earlier decision is called for or not. Coastal Zone Management Plan, CZMP, are prepared by coastal state or union territories as per rules set by CRZ Notification 1991. This is prepared based on identification and categorization of coastal areas for different activities and then submitted to the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change for approval. The ministry then forms a task force for examining these plans. Sometimes one or more natural resources become limiting resources in a given region and that restrict the scope of development portfolios, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Government of India has been sponsoring carrying capacity studies for different regions. The study involves a list of natural resources available, preparation of existing environmental settings, perspective plans and their impact on natural resources through creation of business as usual scenario, identification of hotspots requiring immediate remedial action to overcome air, water or land pollution, formulated of a developed plan which should be for the betterment and a comparison between business as usual and the improved plan for betterment would indicate that future course of action to be adopted for development of the region after it has discussing with the local people and the planners. Now, issue of environmental clearance or rejection letter. First, single window clearance. When a project requires both environmental clearance as well as approval under the Forest Act 1980, proposals for both are required to be given simultaneously to the concerned division of the ministry. The processing is done simultaneously for clearance or rejection, although separate letters may issue. If the project does not involve the diversion of forest land, the case is processed only for environmental clearance. Next is time frame. Once all the requisite documents and data from the project authorities are received and public hearing when required, where required, has been held, assessment and evaluation of the project from the environment angle is completed within 90 days and the decision of the ministry shall be conveyed within the 30 days thereafter. Next is post-project monitoring. It is to be noted that whenever a project is given environment clearance, a set of recommendations and conditions are stipulated by the appraisal committee in a case-to-case basis, which have to be compiled by the project proponent. Once the project is commissioned, the project authorities are required to submit a half-yearly compliance report to the ministry about the compliance of conditions stipulated in the environment clearance order by the ministry. To monitor the implementation of the recommendation and condition stipulated by the appraisal committee, subject to which the environmental clearance has been given, the 6 regional offices of the ministry help in post-project monitoring of the cleared project. Case of non-compliance of the recommendation and conditions by cleared project units are brought to the notice of the ministry, which may then initiate action against the project authorities as described later under obtaining environmental clearance flowchart. Now, come to the main participants of EIA. EIA applies to public and private sectors sections. The 6 main players are, first, those who propose the project. Second, the environmental consultant who prepare EIA on behalf of project proponent. Third, pollution control board, either state or national. Fourth, public has the right to express their opinion. Fifth, the impact assessment agency. And 6th, regional center of the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. The participant in EIA are, first, developer who proposes the project. Second, government department which regulate the project, and the general public as shown in the figure. Now come to the environmental clearance. The entire EIA process up to obtaining environmental clearance as shown in this flowchart. Procedure from environment appraisal in India step-wise are submission of document by investor, scrutiny by multidisciplinary staff or Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Government of India, placement before experts and evaluation by them. Recommendations from appraisal committees are there, passed by Ministry of Environment and Forest. Ministry accept or reject proposals. Now come to the forestry clearance. First, obtaining forestry clearance, various steps involving in examination of cases received under Forest Clearance Act as shown in the flowchart. Application for proposed project to conservator of forest. Next is scrutiny and recommendation of conservator of forest, then to advisory group. First stage approval, then sent to monitoring, and then state government's compliance report. After this goes to Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Government of India after this approval given. Now come to the alternative scenario to evaluation of EIA. Sole objective of EIA is to erase possibilities of environmental damage during construction and implementation of development project. This requires keeping in mind convenience. This requires keeping in mind convenience of those living in the neighborhood and local public, health of laborers and other directly and physically involved in construction. But evolution of EIA is not possible if there is public awareness, awareness of those responsible for protection of environmental quality, reliability of EIA information and report. Before we wrap up, we would like to recap the main points, that is what you have learnt. Developmental projects are all essential components of economic development and progress of a country. To prevent adverse impact of developmental projects and programs and environment, environmental impact assessment or EIA is carried out before the implementation. While development is important, more important is environmental protection so that there is sustainable development and the environmental resources remain available to future generations. EIA is tool for anticipating any harmful effect or developmental activities on the environment, as it clears the project plans only after mitigating all probable damaging effects on the environment. As a tool, EIA improves decision making and ensures environmental safety. Important aspects of EIA are risk assessment, environmental management and post-product monitoring. Integrity, utility and sustainability are the core values of EIA. There is several legal basis of EIA, as it not only appraises environmental health but also the social implication of plant developmental projects. In India, the projects that require clearance for the government are related industries, mining power plants, river valley projects, nuclear power projects and coastal regulation zone. The environmental component of EIA are associated with air, water, organism, noise and land. The EIA report is prepared after collection of baseline data, prediction of impact, evaluation of net cost benefit versus evolution of impacts, monitoring strategies and mitigation strategies and their quantities, estimation, environmental monitoring plans. EIA processes are screening, scoping, collection of baseline data, impact prediction, mitigation measures, public hearing, decision making, monitoring and implementing EMP or risk assessment. Experts from ecosystem management, pollution control, resource management, land use planning, rehabilitation project, appraisal, ecology and NGOs concerned with environmental issues. Clearance or rejection issues are single window clearance, time frame and post project monitoring. The participation in EIA are developer who proposes the project, government department which regulate the project and the general public. An effective EIA is focused, time bound, cost effective and reliable. Dear learners, this is all about lesson number 24, environment impact assessment. We will come again to meet you with a new program for environmental science. Thank you.